Hey, what's up guys? If you're using latest version of Photoshop, I believe Photoshop version 2021 and above, you might experience some odd behavior of text tool or type tool. I wouldn't call this a bug, it's a performance issue reported on some systems, but whatever you call, it's very annoying. Let me highlight you a few of the problems which you could face, and if you're facing them, then continue with this video because you will definitely get rid of them. The solution is very simple and small. But I will highlight you some of the problems which possibly users are experiencing. The first problem, which is very annoying, like if you bring a new text field, you try to edit an existing text, your cursor position is not shown. You just click somewhere and then you don't know, you lost where you are. If you try to type, you possibly have your cursor on the wrong, you have to just readjust again, and you don't know, it's a little difficult. And the other problem, like which you normally see whenever you try to click on a place to type, your cursor starts blinking, but with this performance issue or the error, this cursor is not shown as a blinking, so you just don't know where you're typing and what you're typing. And this problem is even bigger when you're dealing with some right to left and left to right non-English languages. You just don't know what to do. And even the bigger problem is when you are dealing with the bigger text paragraph or maybe a bigger sentences, and you want to just possibly correct the spelling of one word, or possibly you just want to rephrase the one sentence, and you just really don't know which paragraph or which word are you working on. You just try to select one word and you hit a delete button, a backspace, and you just see there that whole line is gone, and sometimes even the whole paragraph is missing. So this is a really big problem. In this video, I will show you how to get rid of this phenomenon, possibly the easiest solution. My name is Mazhar, and at RightSolutions, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new with my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. And now, without any further ado, let's continue to see this solution here. Close any existing document you're working on. I will close mine, and I'll save also the changes, and then head over to the menus in the top and click on edit. And from edit, just go nearly at the bottom, you will see preferences, and from the preferences, just try to find for the options called performance. And after clicking on this performance, you will just see that new pop-up box will come up here. And in this box, just look into the option graphic processor setting. And from here, you will just see the option called advanced settings. Just click on it and you will see a new pop-up will come up. And in this pop-up, just click on this pull-down menu. And from here, just find the option advanced, select the advanced, hit OK, and then click OK again. And that's it. After closing this, just go open a new document or possibly open the existing one. I will open the existing one which I was working on. So just click on it and just click on the anywhere on the text. And here you can just see that after clicking on the top line, my text is already selected. So that means this is working now. So just go and select the next text here, which is cursor position, and now you can see your cursor position is also shown. Now just click on the next text as well, and now you can see that your cursor is blinking. Move your cursor with the arrow keys here and there, and you can just see that you can see the real position of the cursor wherever it is. And now let's see if you are working with a paragraph or maybe a longer line. So just want to change a single word in the text line. So just select. Now you can see that you are able to select single words here. So this had actually shown you how to get rid of in the normal circumstances, almost with the everything, it should work. But in case you are one of the user who did not actually have this gone back to normal as it is shown now, so I'll show you the second solution, which is possibly the most the least solution, but let's see how we do that. So just simply click on close here. And let's say save this document again. So just go back to the edit, click on preferences, go back to the performance again. And now here, you can just see that same graphic processor setting. And from here, you can disable this use graphic processor. So it will just put some legacy settings on your on your application. So just uncheck this tick here. And after that, you can just click on OK. And now let's go open this document again. And now you can just see, after clicking, you will just see that you are able to select the document and click the second one. But You also will notice that your selection box of the text is gone, which possibly you had seen in some older version of the Photoshop. But whatever it is functioning now. So I believe that you, if you did face this problem, so now your problem is solved. If you like this video and you think it was helpful, so please don't forget to give me a thumbs up, share my video, like my video, and I will see you with the next video with some other topic. You have a great day.